more on that as we continue. Now, I do have a moment here with the commissioner of Major League Soccer. The MLS Commissioner Don Garber is with us. And Don, I had a chance to just make sure that you could hear me a moment ago. And so we discussed this. I'd love to get briefly your reaction to the Olympics this summer being postponed till next year.
You know, not surprising at all, Mike. You know, the U.S. men's men are qualifying. They were qualifying down in Costa Rica. Those players from our clubs are back home. The women have already qualified for the Olympics. Not surprising at all. Many of the NGBs, national governing bodies, have been putting pressure on the IOC to postpone the games in Japan. So not surprised in the slightest.
Okay, so I so appreciate you taking this moment here. And we've tried to get the leaders of various different sports on the program to just sort of give the fans an idea of where your head is, what sorts of things you're taking into account right now, what you're hearing from the people whose opinions you value and trust, and then ultimately, most importantly, when we might get a chance to see your sport come back. So what sorts of conversations are you having with people right now, and what data are you looking at as you sort of go through navigating this unprecedented circumstance?
Well, you know, it starts, Mike, that we have a task force of key leaders in the league office. We've got owners that have joined that group. We've got our own medical staff and consultants that we're using. And very importantly, you could imagine that we have owners that are involved in the healthcare system, and they're involved in biotech, and many of them are on the boards of hospitals. So we have an enormous amount of information. Every day, our task force is meeting. We're communicating regularly with our owners, regularly with our team executives, both at the business level and the technical level. And ultimately, what this means for all of us is really the important statement that there are two very important things at play here. One is, you know, there is a real sense of loss of many of sports fans overall, and clearly in the soccer world. You know, our fans are so deeply connected with their clubs. There's a community and a passionate army of people that love their teams and love their players, and there's a real sense of loss when they don't have the opportunity to go to games. But it also is an important statement of the power of sport, and whether that's soccer or any other sport, all coming together to have a very, very strong and powerful voice to ensure that people are staying home, that they're staying safe, that they're staying clean, and that they're prioritizing the things that really matter. Which is social distancing and also connecting to their families and connecting to their loved ones.
And then as you sort of look forward to whenever it is we begin to come out on the other side of this, and none of us pretends that we know at this time, what sorts of things will you need to hear and see in order to make a decision that it is safe and reasonable to come back and start playing again?
You know, it starts, Mike, with that we're following the CDC guidelines, and also this is unique. That's not just federal instructions and guidance. It's also local at the state level and at the county level. And when the CDC had restrictions of people of crowds by May 9th, we suspended or postponed our season till May 10th. And remember, we've only gone through 2 weeks of our season. So our plan is to play as many games as we possibly can. We have a 34-week season. We've only played two. And we're in consultation with our teams and with all others to try to figure out what do we need to do to get back as quickly as we can, ensuring that we're prioritizing the safety of our fans and our staffs and obviously our players. Looking at, can we play behind closed doors? Are there unique and creative concepts that we could have? Could we have regional play? Could we play something that might be fun and exciting during this offseason, during this postponement period, that might be very, very different? And whether it's unique and fun ideas or they're more competitive concepts, we're working hard to put those ideas in place. Once we are comfortable that we can get our players with 3 to 4 weeks of training and that we have the guidance that we can get crowds back into our stadiums, then we will begin the relaunch of our season. Again, our intent is to play as many games as we possibly can. That means moving our regular season later into November. It means moving the MLS Cup back to mid-December, and we've had that for many, many years. We're very confident that we can go back to that format. Our plan is to still have single elimination format that did so well on ESPN last season, and to have the MLS Cup hosted in the team market that earns it.
Don Garber, the commissioner of the MLS, we thank you very much for the time here. Stay safe, and we will check in again as we sort of work through this thing. Thank you, Don.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.